book does an astonishingly good job of asking questions about death and our discomfort with it. And I think each generation has a different relationship with death. So this was our turn. I don't remember when I first read it. I have this very mixed feeling about the horror genre in general. I'm terrified by watching scary movies, and yet I'm attracted to them. So, you know, I sort of dance around it. I get involved, and I'm like, oh, I can't handle it. I found it terrifying and weird, and the reason I was interested in doing it was not because I liked or didn't like that movie. It was actually because I really dug the book and thought there was different ways of doing that book. We were fortunate in this case of getting four extraordinary actors. And I think that allowed us to get deeper into some of the psychological and emotional elements of the story. We're definitely leaning into the mythology and lore of this story. What's interesting is that I think for everybody, what is the evil? What is the sour ground? What are those? What does it mean? I think what's great about it is everybody's going to take a slightly different point of view on that as an audience member, and I think that gives you it not only gives you a little bit of leeway, but it also the unknown I think is a little bit more terrifying than the known. And I think so. I like that the mythology itself is pretty open-ended and doesn't settle it for you. So there's some power there that is intoxicating. It may prove that ultimately you come to discover, as we do, that it's evil, but it's still intoxicating. What's interesting about that kind of tragedy is it forces you to look at the hardest questions that we generally try to avoid in our lives, including death. But it's not just that. It's like, what is family? What is tragedy going to do to you? And in some cases, you survive tragedy. In some cases, you don't. And in this case, we put that fully to the test. What's interesting about the story is you can make a judgment about both of the adult characters' decision-making process, but that doesn't mean you're going to act like either one of them or exactly like one of them. I think I was always attracted to this story, partly because now as a parent, I have two kids, and the question of how far would I go for my child is a pretty relevant idea or resonant as an idea as a parent. And so part of me wants to feel I'll do anything, but there's the cautionary tale in this movie. Like, well, doing everything is not necessarily the right thing to do. Kevin and Dennis are both huge horror fans. I mean, just, you know, over-the-top horror fans. They know they kept talking about movies I've never even heard of, forget about not seen. And so their passion for Stephen King and the genre and the uniqueness of their movies is the reason that we picked them. They are hard, hardcore Stephen King fans. So it was actually funny because there was times where we were like, okay, we got it, it's in the book, but... So it was an interesting process that in a sense, protectors of the flames, we all felt that way. Let's start with Lithgow. I mean, what's so interesting for me, everybody's going to have a different opinion. I never really understood why Judd made the decisions he did in the book. The rational part of me couldn't get my head around it. And when John volunteered to do the role, you knew that he was going to explore Judd and hopefully, and what's great about King is that there's a contradiction in terms in a way about that character. He knows what's wrong, but he can't resist what's wrong. But he knows what's wrong, but he can't resist what's wrong. And so having John, who could play tortured by that, made you feel that the irrational decisions he made sometimes, or illogical is probably a better word, were supported by some angst. So you're kept in a interestingly middle ground where you're not entirely sure exactly, you know, should I not like this guy during this thing, or what am I supposed to feel? And what's great is you can go on a journey with him then. You know, he's not a black and white character. Jason is a fantastic actor. We wanted an actor who could really convey the conviction of a dad, the lovingness of a dad, and the clinicalness of a doctor. And he can turn those two things on. And so we were really confident that in the journey Lewis takes, where part or much of his belief system has to change, you had an actor with enough complexity to do that. I didn't know Amy that well when we first discussed her. I got a chance to see a little bit of her work, and I was so impressed how much she gives without a word. It's something that we forget a lot. We always think about, what are they saying? How they communicate? Well, you can communicate a ton in a nod and your eyes, and she is unbelievable in it. One of my favorite scenes in the movie, when she's confronted with this horrible, like, what am I going to do with this thing? Watching that character struggle with it, she doesn't even say, it's just an amazing moment. Jete, it's always hard to pin your hopes on a child actor. There are plenty of movies, and I've worked on a couple of them, where it was a good try, but not good enough. And the movie will fall apart without that character really being strong and also being believably evil, which is tough for a girl of that age. So she did a fantastic job of both playing the sweet daughter and also playing the malevolent force that she becomes. They don't say a lot, so they're super cute, which is what their job is to be, and they are a little bit like the lamb sitting in the middle of all these predators. And will the lamb survive or not? When we were debating what church should look like and how you should feel, et cetera, we went back to, I think it was the original book cover, and we looked a lot at that cat. And in a way, that's what we were drawing off of as we looked at the different cats that we looked at. You don't know what you're going to get, especially with cats, but animal training is always a little bit difficult. So in this case, we had five churches that all did different things, which is kind of cool. And from a story point of view, though, Church is a really beloved figure. It's really interesting to me because obviously he can't say anything, he can't participate on certain levels, but people seem to just really respond to the idea of a cat having something that's not just right and to going to, oh my God, it's completely dangerous. And the audience loves the character. I think it's always interesting to work with directors when they work in a team because you think of it as such a single job. And the idea that somebody's going to split it up is always like, really, how does that work exactly? So usually one person's a little more talkative than the other in my experience, and that person is the one who sort of takes the lead in the sense of communication. But what's interesting is if you talk to Kevin about something, he has a very different insight than Dennis. Not better or worse, just different. And so, you know, you could see them exploring one thing and then it would change a little bit and it would explore another, which represented one or the other's slightly different thought. And I think that can be dangerous because it can feel indecisive, but in this case, it was within a very small parameter of the difference. Thematically, what I find so interesting about the book and both movies is you can't run from death. It's going to find you. So you can't hide from the concept. It's going to either find you or it's going to find somebody near and dear to you. I think everybody has a different definition of what's a great horror film. For me, it's the what's not there that makes it for me. I'm not the biggest fan of slasher movies, for instance, because everything's there on the screen. The blood, the knife, the evil thing. I like the unknown. Unknown is more terrifying to me. I think what's interesting is that the book and the movie, I don't think the terrifying is... it is wildly discomforting. On an emotional level, it puts you in really uncomfortable positions. So I kind of felt the first time I saw the movie, I was just sort of like, I found myself really crunched in. It wasn't necessarily terrifying. It was just the dread. I would say dread is this movie's and this book's strength, is just how awful it is and how you can feel the worst news coming, you know, the worse and worse and worse. And so you just really... you get to that point where you can't take it in a way, and then that's the moment where the movie just accelerates. Stephen has the ability to shine a light in a corner where you really don't want to go. I think he's very unafraid. It's very decisive in terms of what he's exploring. Now, I don't know how his process works. For him, it might be a process of discovery, but as a reader, it's a process of journey into dark, unknown, weird places sometimes, you know? And he seems to have that ability to shine a light in the corner where you really didn't want to go.